चैप्टर टू अलजेब्रा द फर्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस द रेशनल एक्सपेंशन कैन बी रिटन एज पी ऑफ एक्स बाय क्यू ऑफ एक्स सो पी ऑफ एक्स इज ए पॉलिनोमियल कैन बी टेकन एज ए नॉट एक्स पावर एन ए वन एक्स पावर एन माइनस वन एक्सेट्रा अप टू ए एन qx can be written as b naught x power m plus b1 x power m minus 1 etc up to bm so qx is not equal to 0 denominator value is not equal to 0 so in the first concept in the p of x polynomial p of x which is less than q of x suppose p of x is smaller q of x is bigger means this is called as proper rational expansion suppose the polynomial p of x which is greater than or equal to q of x is called improper rational expansion so the improper fraction can be expressed as p of x by q of x polynomial p of x by q of x equal to f of x plus r of x by q of x or otherwise q plus r by d quotient plus remainder by divisor first one the denominator contains non repeated linear factors the first property of partial fraction p of x by q of x can be resolved into partial fractions suppose these two roots are non repeated means a by ax plus b b by cx plus d for example 3x plus 7 by x minus 1 into x minus 2 this can be resolved into partial fraction can be taken as these two are non repeated factors so a by x plus 1 x minus 1 b by x minus 2 in this result the power of x is 1 x into x is x square so strictly numerator is less than the denominator second example suppose x plus resolve into partial fraction x plus 4 by x square minus 4 into x plus 1 suppose x square minus 4 a square minus b square formula a square minus b square formula is a plus b into a minus b formula so x square minus 4 is x square minus 2 square a plus b into a minus b so x square plus 4 can be written as x plus 2 into x minus 2 into x plus 1 in this result three non repeated linear factors this can be taken as a by x plus 2 plus b by x minus 2 plus c by x plus 1 okay next one denominator contains linear factors repeated n times first one is non repeated factors this one is repeated factors this result is also numerator is less than the denominator so the power of x is 1 x this one is square so x square into x is x cube so surely numerator is less than the denominator for example 9x plus 1 plus 7 by x plus 4 into x plus 1 whole square in this result the repeated factors can be taken as a by x plus 4 b by this can be written in two times so first one is b by x plus 1 again we have to take c by x plus 1 the whole square second example x plus 1 by x minus 2 whole square into x plus 3 can be taken as this is a square term so a by x minus 2 b by x minus 2 whole square finally c by x plus 3 next one The denominator contains quadratic factor which cannot be factorized into linear factor. Suppose the denominator is not possible to compute the linear factor, means we have to apply the another property, 2x plus 1 by x, example 2x plus 1 by x minus 1 into x square plus 1. So in this not to compute the linear factor for this result, so a by x minus 1 plus, this can be taken as bx plus c by x square plus 1. Exercise 2.1. Resolve into partial fraction for the following. Sum number 1. 3x plus 7 by x square minus 3x plus 2. And this is the problem. In this problem, first we have to check numerator is less than the denominator. So, power of x is 1 and the leading power is 2. So, strictly 1 is less than 2. So, numerator is less than the denominator. 3x plus 7 by x square minus 3x plus 2 equal to 3x plus 7 is, this can be taken in the factor s, means x minus 2 into x minus 1. So already studied in the 10th standard in the factorization. So x minus 2 into x plus 1. So 3x plus 7 by x minus 2 into x minus 1 can be taken non-repeated linear factors. So a by x minus 2 plus b by x minus 1. So in this result, multiplying numerator by x minus 2 into x minus 1 on both sides. So this result is multiplying by denominator. So 3x plus 7 into x minus 2 into x plus 1 by x minus 1 by x minus 2 into x minus 1 equal to a into same result. So x minus 2 into x minus 1 by x minus 2, b into again multiply x minus 2 into x minus 1 by x minus 1. So these two terms are cancelled. So remaining term is 3x plus 7 equal to x minus 2 cancel, a into x minus 1 plus b into x minus 2 is equation number 1. In this result, we have to compute either a or b. Suppose we have to compute b, means try to make it as a is become 0. So we have to set x equal to 1, means automatically a value is become 0. We have to compute b value. So put x equal to 1 in equation number 1. So 3 into 1 plus 7 equal to a into 1 minus 1 is 0, b into 1 minus 2. So 3 into 1 plus 7 equal to b into 1 minus 2. So 3 plus 7 equal to b into minus 1. 10 equal to b into minus 1. B equal to minus 10. So b value is already get b value. So next, we have to try to make it as b values become 0. So we have to put x equal to 2, 2 minus 2 is 0. So we have to set x equal to 2 in equation number 1. Same equation, 3 into 2 plus 7 equal to a into 2 minus 1. So this time is become 0. So 6 plus 7 equal to a into 1. So a equal to 13. So finally, the non-repeated linear factors are a by x minus 2 plus b by x minus 1. So a value is 13 by x minus 2, b value is minus 10, so minus 10 by x minus 1, hence the problem. Again, let us move to problem number 3. Resolve into partial fraction 1 by x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square. So this is the repeated linear factor. So 1 by x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square is a by x minus 1. This is square. So b by x plus 2 plus c by x plus 2 whole square. Equation number 1. Multiplying this denominator, this can be taken in numerator of LHS as well as RHS. So x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square multiply numerator. And denominator can be taken as x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square, a into x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square by x minus 1 plus b into x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square by x plus 2, c into x minus 1 into x plus 2 whole square by x plus 2 whole square. These two terms are cancelled, 1, x minus 1 cancel, a into x plus 2 whole square, again x plus 2, 1 power is cancelled. So x, b into x minus 1 into x plus 2, c into these two terms are cancelled, c into x minus 1, equation number 2. In this problem, a, b, c are there, try to make it as any two terms are become 0. Suppose b and c are 0 means we have to compute a. Suppose a and c are 0 means we have to compute b. So in this problem, suppose we have to set x equal to 1, 1 minus 1, 0, b value 0. Again, we have to set x equal to 1, c value is also 0. So we have to set x equal to 1 in equation number 2. So 1 equal to a into 1 plus 2 whole square. This one is 0, this time is also 0. So 1 equal to a into 3 square, 1 equal to a into 9, a equal to 1 by 9. Again, put x equal to minus 2 in equation number 2, 1 equal to a into 0, b is 0, c, we get to a c only, c equal to minus 2 minus 1, 1 equal to c into minus 3, c equal to minus 1 by 3. Again, put x equal to 0 in equation number 2, we got to set 0 equal 0 in 2, 1 equal to a into 2 square, b into minus 1 into 2, c into minus 1. So 1 equal to 4a minus 2b minus c. 1 equal to 4 into, see, a value was already known, a value is 1 by 9 minus 2 into b value is not unknown plus again c value is minus 1 by 3, so minus into minus plus 1 by 3. 1 equal to 4 by 9 plus 1 by 3 minus 2b. 1 equal to LCM 4 plus 3 by 9 minus 2b. 1 equal to 7 by 9 minus 2b, 9 equal to 7 minus 18b, 9 minus 7 equal to minus 18b, 9 minus 7 is 2 equal to minus 18b, minus 2 by 18 equal to b, minus 1 by 9 equal to b. So the a value is a by x minus 1, so 1 by 9 by x minus 1, and b value is minus 1 by 9, so minus 1 by 9 by x plus 2 minus c value is 1 by 3 by x plus 2 whole square. This ends the problem.